Hi, I'm Julie Weber of Liberate Ministries. Have you ever sat under a teaching and heard the words abortion, miscarriage, stillbirth, sudden infant death syndrome, and thought to yourself, oh, there are those words again. I wonder what they really mean. They never pertain to my life. Please don't mention them again. Well, today's topic is, what is abortion, miscarriage, stillbirth, sudden infant death syndrome, and how can they pertain to my life? You can find the website links for each of these definitions attached to this video. The definition of abortion means, also called voluntary abortion, the removal of an embryo or fetus from the uterus in order to end a pregnancy. The definition of miscarriage means the expulsion of a fetus before it is viable, especially between the third and seventh months of pregnancy. Spontaneous abortion. The definition of a stillbirth means the birth of a dead child or organism. The sudden infant death syndrome, also known as SIDS, refers to the unexplained death of a child less than 1 year old. Well, looking at the definition of abortion and miscarriage, they both mean the same thing. Expelling of the fetus. Well, quoted from my Lady Liberty workbook on pages 76 and 77, and this is my workbook, my Lady Liberty workbook, and I'm going to be quoting a lot from it today. Women who have experienced miscarriage, stillbirth, sudden infant death syndrome, and abortion all experience loss. These losses are tough to take. Our society offers more support and understanding for these losses, except in abortion. Yet there is still a lot of misunderstanding about each of these types of death. Some obvious differences are that women who abort choose to terminate their pregnancy. The mother experiencing miscarriage, stillbirth, or sudden infant death syndrome did not choose for their child's life to end. As a result, mothers who experience these types of deaths are more focused on the question of why. Well, quoted from my Lady Liberty workbook on page 73, each loss brings disturbance and emotional pain into our lives. Yet grief is a normal process, a common experience. You can't pray it away. It is an emotional process. And as people, we need to go through it, not around it. In today's culture, when we lose a loved one or a friend, we are allowed time to outwardly grieve. People understand that there has been a death. It is acceptable for people to take funeral leave, vacation, and sometimes even an extended leave of absence following the death of someone close to them. The same is not true after you have had an abortion. Most often, people are not given time to outwardly grieve. Women and men choosing abortion are caught between pro-abortionists who believe that abortion is nothing more than a blob of tissue, and pro-lifers who believe that abortion is the death of a child. The moral debate continues in our society, and as a result, women and men are not encouraged or allowed to outwardly express their grief. everything is kept hidden after an abortion, including the parents' feelings of loss and grief. Well, quoted on in my Lady Liberty workbook on page 74, Jesus knew grief. In Isaiah 53:3, he was despised and rejected, a man of sorrows, acquainted with deepest grief. We turned our backs on him and looked the other way. He was despised and we did not care. Well, quoted from my Lady Liberty workbook again on page 77, even Jesus asks us the question, why? Matthew 27:46, about the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, and I think it's pronounced, Eli, Eli, lama sabachthani, which means, my God, why have you forsaken me? Having no answer to the question of why can make us angry. But at some point, your question of why will turn to what can I gain from this experience going forward? Well, knowing why doesn't remove the painful circumstance. In the Bible, Paul came to accept why he was suffering in prison. And we read in 2 Timothy 1:12, that's why I am suffering the way I am, but I am not ashamed. I know the one I have believed in. I am sure he is able to take care of what I have given him. I can trust him with it until the day he returns as judge. This is also the case for us as post-abortive women. Knowing why we are suffering doesn't ease the hurt. It still hurts. However, knowing why may move us closer to acceptance of what we have to go through as a result of having the abortion. In closing, so how could each of these pertain to your life? Well, if you're single, this video gives you and your friends information in case you encounter of these losses. If you're in a relationship, by either cohabiting or married, and you have experienced one of these childbearing losses, this teaching could confirm your experience or explain what you're experiencing. Hopefully, this teaching gives you a better understanding of what the differences between abortion, miscarriage, stillbirth, and sudden infant death syndrome are. Well, thanks for watching. Live life liberated.